I am outside what is probably the only brewery that's situated in a repurposed barn on the eastern side of PA. So let's check out the brewing facility for Great Barn Brewery.
Unlock your mind, and then you'll be free to clear your head.
All right, so that's the brewery. Let's go check out the tap room, which is about 40 minutes east over in New Hope, PA. Let's go.
You can't look back, you gotta look ahead instead. So a bad love affair got you down.
So I'm here with Maryana Ferguson of Great Barn Brewery here, and we're going to ask a couple of questions about the brewery, and we're going to try some of their plethora of beers that they have here. So Maryana, thank you so much for sitting down with me.
You're welcome.
So now, what made you guys come up with the idea of opening a brewery on a farm?
We had a farm in the family for 40 years, and the fields were farmed, and we kind of were looking for a next transition, taking the business to the next step. My father-in-law built this fantastic barn, which used to be a goat dairy.
Oh, cool.
So we kind of took it and like keep it the history alive.
Yeah.
Let's keep it the farming tradition alive in the family, but do something that is modern and that is also profitable in keeping the land in use. So we came up with an idea of growing our barley for all of our beers.
Okay.
And this is our beers right here. So
Wow. We
started farming about 3-4 years ago. We're
okay.
gonna learn about different varieties of barley and
cool.
how they perform in Pennsylvania climates and soils.
Okay.
And this is the fruit of our labor. And
now then, here at the tasting room in New Hope, you guys have bottles and cans, the whole nine
That's
yards.
That's right. We have bottles and cans. There's going to be more cans coming out. We have some bottles.
22-ounce bottles.
Yeah, 22-ounce.
22-ounce bottles.
12%.
Nice. Yeah,
that's your standard breakfast beer
cool.
right there.
So let's get to it. What do we got here?
We have our IPA.
Okay.
We have our Kolsch.
Okay.
We have our hazy IPA. We
okay.
have our peach ale. Peanut butter chocolate dunkel is our baby.
It's the one that caught my eye.
That's the one that's delicious. And then you move on to the dark ones like the stout. And then I threw a little bit of a horseradish in there just because.
Okay. All right.
Just because.
So this is what, where the
this
Delaware
is
a,
yeah,
am I?
Where the Delaware am I? Take a look at our artwork in the can. That's
super smooth body. I really like it. And just look at the lacing on that glass.
It's three.
Beautiful.
Three hops and dry hop also.
Okay. Oh, dry hop too.
Yep.
Nice. It's not that bitter. It's actually even a little
our
bit
IPAs,
sweet in there too.
Yes, our IPAs. Well, we don't control what the flavor of the barley produces, you know, so it's I think it has to do, and I forgot to mention the water factor. The well water is the supreme, coming from the farm spring.
Awesome.
And that's what it tastes
so
like.
So this next one is the Kolsch.
Kolsch.
Okay.
Kolsch. I like Kolsch. We all
okay.
love our Kolsch.
Oh, cheers.
The Cologne style German ale, nice and drinkable any day. Any time of the year.
Light,
it's
crisp.
Very light, a little bit of a honey. There's a little, the malt gives out a little bit of a honey, like of a sweetness to it. Like
yeah, a little lemon, a little honey, nice and crisp.
A biscuit.
This is
our porter.
Okay.
It's brewed
Massive
with,
deception. All right.
Yes.
Dig it.
There's a story behind it.
Mmm. Ooh, with the vanilla and maple syrup.
It's deceptive. Yes. There's a maple syrup, there's vanilla in there.
Oh, wow. Oh, my gosh.
It's not super sticky and heavy.
Yeah, it's not heavy. It's quite light. But the notes of just the vanilla topping off the maple syrup and just the very, it's not even very overly sweet. It's a light sweetness that just.
Yeah, for a winter day.
Everything marries together so nice.
Yeah, for the dark beer lovers, that's your go-to.
Oh, you got one right here. Jeez, this is delicious.
All right.
So this is the
this is our stout.
Okay.
This is our stout. Just your
straightforward oatmeal stout. Okay.
Oatmeal stout. The very first brewer that worked for us, his name was Christopher Bowen. He's also a beer historian.
Okay.
And He got a gold medal at the Colorado
Beer Festival. Oh, the Great American Beer Festival.
For the
Sweet.
Stout, yes. So that's a winning
cool
recipe.
Yeah, so it's a little thinner than a lot of other stouts, but it's still a medium to full body, and it's got that nice roasted, slightly bitter taste to it.
Move on to our peanut butter dunkel.
Yes.
Now look
peanut
at the,
butter,
look at the color of the dunkel.
All right.
Now that's a dunkel. Dunkel means dark. Dark wheat ale. Mm. Now this one is the one that you can drink in the summer, winter, and fall.
Yeah.
And don't feel guilty about it.
Oh my gosh. I
it's tasty.
I don't even have to taste it. Just the smell alone does it for me.
Mm. And I'll just eat a pepperoni.
Wow, that wheat base just adds such a nice...
It smooths it out. Yeah. It makes it very drinkable, very light, adds a body to it.
It's a nice nice malt backbone, ties in perfectly with the chocolate, the touch of peanut butter, and touch of sweetness. It's just what's next.
Now that one is a pear, no, peach. I don't know.
Oh,
maybe
wow.
It'll work, maybe not.
Almost crystal clear
the
body.
Peach. It's very light. Mm. Very crisp. It's just, you know, something that we have people that like heavy beers, people
that and it's light definitely beers. It's definitely the type of between this and the Kolsch, I think, is a very nice intermediate beer. A nice
little
almost like a little Saison type funk scent to it too. It's kind of neat.
Well, they're all authentic farmhouse ale, so whatever is definitely, whatever pollen was floating in the air that day.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it's all
so you definitely get the peach. It's not overly sweet, not overly bitter, and you still, it's almost like a, actually kind of has, I feel like it's leaning more towards like a Saison type of funk flavor to it. It's really neat. So this is the barrel-aged old ale, right?
Yes.
Okay.
This one has a very interesting story to it. Our very first brewmaster, he was a beer historian.
Okay.
He found this recipe in 1852. It was a rescue expedition that was happening that was organized by Queen Victoria. There was a team of explorers that got stuck in the Arctic, and they are going to rescue them somewhere up in Canada. So that she ordered to brew this ale to be brought on board, either to enjoy on board or to enjoy well after they rescued them and enjoy it on board. So the story is there just, you know, that beer was commissioned by the Queen, and that's the original recreated
recipe.
Really
cool.
It was barrel aged for 9 months in whiskey barrels. It's very thick. There's plum in there. Oh, I'm not gonna say. That's your job.
No, it's all good. It's all good. But yeah, definitely nice warm whiskey taste to it, and definitely getting like the plum, the fig, the dark stone fruit kind of stuff.
Right.
And with that nice full body, definitely pulling out some of that molasses flavor to it,
right,
too.
Right. Yeah.
But Maryana, thank you so much for sitting down with me, talking some beer with me, talking some history. I had a blast. I hope you had a blast, too. And hope to stop by again soon.
Yeah, and I'll see you at the beer festival or whatever one you're going to.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure we'll run into each other
at
another beer festival.
We'll go to them all. Yep.
All right. Well, thank you so much. So that's it for my visit here at Great Barn Brewery. Big thanks to the whole crew for showing me around the brewery itself and the tap room. If you want to stop by one of the events at the brewery, make sure you like Great Barn Brewery's Facebook page. Otherwise, swing by New Hope, try out their tap room, try out their plethora of beers, and I'm promising you, you're going to have a hell of a good time. But make sure you tell them AJ sent you. So with that being said, I'm going to sign off saying, happy drinking, my friends. Thank you for watching. Hit that subscribe button down in the corner. And I'll see you next time.